Hi, I'm Heather Hanna. I live in Terrace, BC, and have been coaching here now for almost 2 years. I coach from the preliminary levels through to senior silver, and I coach free skate, dance, and skills. So I thought long and hard about my coaching philosophy, and basically I came up with this. I feel that as a coach, I have a lot of influence over these young skaters, and that's why I strive to be a positive role model for them. And I do that by trying to always show them how passionate I am about skating and how passionate I am about helping them succeed. I feel very strongly that as a coach, it's important that I give the skaters the tools they need to achieve their goals, like to do their best, and also to make sure that they're having fun. I think that skating is discipline, skating is hard work, but it also needs to be fun. And so, as a coach, I feel that it's my job to help kind of combine those three things and make sure that the skater knows that they need all those three things. And yeah, ultimately, I just think that as a coach, it's important that I show the skaters or teach the skaters that skating can be a lifelong passion and that it's something that they'll always have. And my coach did that for me, and I'll be forever grateful. So I just think that's really important for me as a coach to help the skaters realize that they can take it however far they want to take it and they'll always have it. So yeah. So let's talk about my strengths. I feel that I'm a very good motivator for the skaters. I'm always trying to give them positive feedback, at least something positive in every lesson. And so yeah, I think those are my strengths. I'm positive and I'm a good motivator. And I also think that I'm pretty good at picking out corrections, which kind of, this kind of leads into my challenges now. I'm good at picking out corrections at the lower levels, but one of my challenges is struggling to find corrections at the higher levels, like senior silver levels, when skaters are landing jumps consistently. I feel like sometimes I might be missing things that could help them do that jump better because they've just been doing it the same for so long. So I think that's one area that I can improve. And yeah, another challenge, I guess, is I think I give the kids information overload sometimes. I have so much to say, and I feel like the lessons are so short, and so I struggle to give them sort of one piece of information at a time, something that their brain can actually grasp. So I also need to work on that. But yeah. And so my coaching goals, yeah, I guess it kind of ties into my coaching philosophy. Sort of my number one is to help skaters achieve their goals and pursue their dreams, whatever that may be. I want the skaters to know that they can have fun on the ice. I want to teach them how to be disciplined and how to work hard to achieve their goals. I think that's really important, and I think coaches have the ability to do that. One of my goals is giving them the tools that they need to succeed. So whether that be attending seminars and getting extra information, or just, going online, just kind of keeping up to date with skating so that I can help them the best that I can. Oh, another one of my goals is trying to teach skaters body awareness, because it's something that I didn't have when I was a younger skater, and I developed it as an adult, so I try and incorporate that into my coaching, and it's one of my goals to always sort of tap into their body awareness, ask them questions about what that felt like, what do you think went wrong in that? What do you feel? So just trying to make them think about that instead of just telling them what they did wrong or what they could work on. And yeah, I think just another goal, just bringing it back to the coaching philosophy is just to teach skaters that skating can be a lifelong passion and that it's something that will always be with them, and it doesn't have to end, say, after high school, that they'll have it forever. So, yeah, that's me and my coaching.
Okay, hello. So, this is Michaela Forrest, and she is a Star 5. And today we're going to be working on the forward crossovers, and we're going to break it down by forward circle thrust and then the under push. And then we're going to try and get her to increase her speed in her forward crossovers. So first, I want to see Michaela's nice foot position on her circle thrust, her stretch. So Michaela, can you show me your position under your foot on a circle thrust? Okay, nice. So yeah, straight, she has a straight knee, and then you want to point your toe, point, 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 and maybe just a little bit higher. Make sure your knees over your ankle. Good. Okay, so that's the position that I want to see on your circle thrust. Okay? And then let's talk about your upper body. What does your upper body do?
Into
the
circle.
Yeah, so we want to engage our core, and you're going to twist your shoulders into the circle, and then you're going to bend down low on the knees, and you're just going to stay there. So it's like you're using that core to hold you in position the whole time. Okay, so we're gonna see forward circle thrust. So, position, make sure your arms are on your shoulders are on the circle, and then bend knees. I want you to use your full blade. So on the circle thrust itself, I want you to bend and then push through your whole blade. So stretch, yeah, and then stretch through your toe. Yeah, because sometimes skaters like to just push with their heel. And that's not using the whole blade, so we're going to bend and then push all the way through the blade through the toe. Okay, so can you show me for a little bit? Okay. let's move on. So now we're going to work on our underfoot. So you have that strong forward push on the crossover. And then the second part is that nice underfoot, right? And do we want to use our whole blade still?
Yes.
Yes. Okay, so you got to stay low in the knee. And then use the whole blade, bend, and push. You want to leave your blade on the ice for as long as you can. And then push away. So what we're going to do is you're going to go around the circle. You can do like one really strong circle thrust. So one strong circle thrust, and then cross it. And then you're just going to do a full circle of under pushes. Okay? And so what happens when we do the under pushes is your body, your upper body is probably going to want to twist away from or to outside of the circle. So you're going to have to really engage your core, twist it in, like tighten those tummy muscles, pull, make sure those arms are in front of your belly button, behind your bum, and then show me those strong, under pushes. And you want to point your toe, right? So you're using the whole blade, pushing away, stretch, point the toe. Okay. What I should see on those under pushes. Okay? So go the other way. Think about your upper body. Is that way a little bit harder?
Yeah.
So I think for you need to concentrate more on the your torso twisting into the circle and having that arm break almost across your body, because you want it, like it wants to shift outside the circle. So holding that really, really tight, tight abs. Because the push is not bad, but you're just drifting. So can you show me that drift one more time? And just really concentrate on your upper body and that your arms are level. You can almost think of this arm being, your back arm being a little bit higher, maybe. circle thrust, two counts on the underfoot.
Okay, so lesson number one was my stroking lesson with Michaela. I'm just going to read off my notes here. So, yeah, we worked on forward crossovers, and what I liked from that lesson was I thought I chose good progressions for that skill to help her with her strong crossovers and speed. I liked that I noticed her fixing her corrections of her body awareness and the stretch of her free leg. And I liked that I could actually see her increase her speed when she used the counting drill. So those were what I liked. What I don't think worked was I would have liked to see her keep her foot of the under push on the ice a little bit longer, so that she was using the whole blade, especially going clockwise. And I would have liked to see her get even lower in her knees. So maybe I should have spent more time on those two things. I stayed pretty well on track with my lesson plan. I didn't really deviate. And what would I do differently or the same next time? So next time I would focus more on staying low in the knees on the under push progression and using, like, helping her feel that she's using more of the blade. And then emphasize it when holding the crossovers for the two counts each. And I would continue to talk about twisting the torso, arm positions, free leg stretch. And again, I would use the counting drill because it focused on control and increasing speed. So yeah, there were some good things in that lesson, but I definitely could focus more on that under push. I think she needs that.
Okay. All right, so we're going to do a dance lesson. This is Trinity. She is a star one, and we're going to be teaching her the progressions for the canasta. So we'll just start on the circle. Okay, so you're just going to showcase a nice circle thrust on the circle, okay? So keeping your body turned in the circle, using bending your knees, using a full blade push. Try and reach that underfoot. Reach, reach, reach. Okay, so, can you reach that underfoot? Okay, that was looking a little like a crossover. Remember our progressive? Wants just to try and have it in front. So you're going to push, and then slide it right beside, under, and then push. Okay, we don't want to cross it over. Okay, let's add a shaft aid to that progressive, okay? So you're going to do your progressive. So we'll count, we'll add count. So we're going to count 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay? Okay, we're gonna do that one more time. Can you that, or in dance, we have to get nice and low on our knees. And you're going to focus on this undercut, right? Try and send your foot. See how far you can send your foot away from your leg. Okay? Okay, we'll do that one more time. When it's behind you, it's gonna go to the same level in the front, okay? Kind of like a pendulum. You know what a pendulum is? No? I don't even know how to explain a pendulum. But it goes, it's kind of equal, okay? So it goes in the back equal to the front, okay? Same height. So I don't want your back leg drop and then your front leg too high, okay? Okay, so, and focus on your knees, right? And then when you come up, so when you swing that leg through, I want to see rise up in the knee. So we're just going to do swing rolls down the line. So it's going to be swing. And then keep that stretch right through. Stretch, point your toe, and point your toe. Okay, try to keep your leg nice and straight the whole way. Okay? Like the whole way through the swing. Let's do that one more time. And, yeah. One, two. Coming up in the swing roll, you don't bend your knee, okay? That's what I mean. Keep that knee almost locked. So it's locked behind, and then it's locked in the front, yeah? Because you sometimes, you have a nice stretch behind, and then it kind of starts bending. But we'll work on that. Okay, now let's go to the circle. We're going to do your slide chassis, okay? So the slide chassis, you're just going to push on your left outside edge, all I want to see. Push, feet together, and slide. Keeping your upper body up, okay? Try not to bend. Stick your butt out. You keep your upper body up, okay? Push, feet come together, and slide. Nice toe point. Okay, let's go the other way. Okay. So you can also work every time you push and dance, right? Every time you push, you should work on that toe point, right? Lock that knee and point that toe as much as you can. Okay, cross roll. Okay, so let's go down here. I just want you to really focus on your outside edge, okay? So you're gonna go outside edge, stretch. Focus on kind of the line, staying on the line, and just going, weaving over top of the line a little bit. So you're just going to go from one side of the line, other side of the line, one side of the line, stretch that knee, and then stretch. There we go. Okay, so now we'll kind of put some pieces together, okay? So, what is it? We want to do the swing, swing, roll, slide, chassis. Swing, roll, slide, chassis. So we'll do that down the line, okay? So we're going to do your swing, roll, then step on the outside edge, feet together, slide, chassis, swing, roll. Thank you. bend your knees, right? You bend your knee into the roll, and then you come up. Over today. We went over our progressives, okay, our progressive chassés, our swing rolls, our cross rolls, right? Important to bend your knees, keep your upper body back. That was awesome. Next time we'll put it into the dance on the pattern. Okay, good job.
So lesson two was dance. I did the canasta with Trinity, and so during that lesson, what worked, I feel, was that I use repetition. Repetition worked for Trinity. She needs to do things over and over to get something. And so we spent a lot of time on her swing rolls so that she could try and get that knee bend and actually create a lobe on her swing rolls. And I think that getting her to follow behind me worked well so that she could see my pattern. And after that, the shape of her swing rolls was better. What didn't work, she still struggles on stretching her free leg and actually lifting it up off the ice. So maybe I need to do more progressions so that she can feel that stretch. Maybe just spending more time at the boards, like isolating that. And the under push exercise, after watching the video of me coaching her, I realized that that exercise maybe was a bit too hard for her. I could think about using a different exercise for that. Did I deviate from the lesson plan? Yes. I spent so much time on Trinity's swing rolls because they just need so much work. I was going to add the cross, like a cross roll and then a swing roll, so doing the cross roll into the swing roll. But I didn't even get to that with her because I feel like her swing rolls just needed so much extra work. So I spent a lot of time on the swing rolls. And what would I do different? So like I said previously, because she needs so much work on stretching of her free leg, like that first push in her progressive, I feel like I could spend more time on that just at the boards, helping her realize how to stretch her leg, how to use her butt to get that leg up off the ice. And maybe assisting her with her balance, if I was to use that under push exercise, maybe helping her like hold her arms so that she's not so wobbly, that maybe would help next time. And using a marker and drawing the lobes down the ice for the swing rolls, I could also add next time. So that was that lesson.
Okay, so this is Ethan, and now we're going to be doing his jump lesson. So we're going to work on a single loop. We'll start two, we're going to get him going on a single loop. So can I start with seeing your inside three turn? So we're going to go to the blue line, and we're going to try and do this nice inside three turn on a curve. So you're going to start with your right arm in front, you're going to push and hold your eight. Right arm nice and back. Okay, so do you feel yourself going a little bit? No, you don't? Okay, I want you to think about, actually let's come to the board. And your left foot in front, and then what you're gonna do is you're just kind of lean and hit your hip on the board. Okay, so this knee's gonna bend more, this one, and put it closer to the boards. Yeah, and then this one out in front here a little bit more. Yeah, and then bend. Good. Okay, so see how you're tipping a little bit into the boards like this. Okay, that's what I almost want you to feel like on your three turn. Okay, you're doing a three turn and you're over this side. Okay, you're leaning over this right side. You're not too tall. Okay, so you want to lean. Okay, try again. Okay, so this time you're going to go and you're going to do three claps with your hands. Okay, so you're doing your three turns and you're going to go clap, clap, clap. Making sure that your H position is nice and tall. These legs are crossed and you don't drop this down, okay? Strong H position. Okay, so let's see if we can start the clap, clap, clap sooner and have it a little bit higher, okay? Try not to go for your hips. Try and go kind of in your waist, okay? So breathe through. So three turns, clap, clap, clap. Okay, I understand what you said. That one looks better though. That one looks better. Clap, clap, clap. Okay. Now, remember that our loop isn't going to go out that way. We're going to try and keep it on a nice little tight curve here. So you're going to go here, turn, clap, clap, clap. Okay? Keep it on a nice little curve. Keep that strong, okay? Is your tummy tight when you're doing this? Or do you think about your tummy? No? Oh. Okay, keep your abs nice and strong and keep them twisted. So your left arm should be across your belly button, okay? That should be your position. One more of these. Three, two, and clap, clap, clap. Okay. So now we're going to go to the boards. And we're going to do a progression forward single loop. So you're gonna have your hands along the board. You're gonna step, you can just watch this one, okay? You're gonna step into your three turn, tap the board with your foot, rotate, so do backwards three turn, and then jump into backwards, okay? Let me show you again. Yeah? Okay. So hands on the board, step in with your right three turn. Strong, back to three turns, and don't smack your knee on the board. Okay. So back, and then, so, so from this point, smacking your foot on the board, then you just let go of the board, let go, do a nice little three turn. Yeah. Yeah, I didn't really tell you. You can, yeah, let go of the board to do that part. Awesome. Okay. Try it again. Try and make sure you tap this toe, like the ball of your foot, or the big, right here. Tap it, hit the board. Okay? Hit the board. And open up. And go. Okay? You're doing good. We try that on the line now, so without any boarding, you're going to do the same thing. You're going to go down the line, so strong, strong, and jump to back. Pretty much just did a loop there. But can you check, remember that turn, that backwards three turn. And then you're bringing your upper body in before you're jumping. So remember, strong. Hold strong. You held it strong, and then you brought it in this way, okay? So remember, you want it strong over this side. Can I just see that three turn again? The three turn hold. Hold. Good. So I want to see that. I want to see your three turn hold, bend, and then everything comes in together, okay? So you do your strong three turn hold, then you bend, and then you jump, and bring your upper body. Go to the board. So, show me your landing glide position. You can go just here. Yeah. Oh. Okay. Is it stretch? Yeah. And maybe a little higher. Okay. I want to see that. Okay. On the end of that jump, with nice strong arms. Okay. Maybe going into that loop with some speed now? Yeah? So let's set it up. Maybe you can just do like one or two crossovers. You do push into your inside three with your left arm, and that worked for you. So I told you to do it with the right arm in front on the line, but that, I'm okay with you, this is actually probably right. It works, okay? So that's good. So crossovers, do it again, yep. Crossover, and... Yeah, that one? Did you notice how it was a little bit this way? You did? Yeah? Okay. I want you to think now, you're going to push and you're going to hold your three turn for a little bit longer. Okay, so you're going to do crossovers. Okay, and hold, and then just jump. So just a little bit longer. Hold a little bit longer. Sorted out, but nice loop. Good loop. Okay, so you can do it at the board. Yes, close to the board. Bend this knee. Okay, and stretch. Think of something sending, like you're sending something out of your toe pick. You know, like it's going all the way through your body, through your leg, through out your toe. So all this is going to be nice and straight. Okay, just show me a landing glide. So backward glide. Okay, so again, you're a little bit down here, so tall. Think like back up and to the side. Like squeeze these muscles together. Squeeze them together. Okay, just like a landing leg. Okay. I almost want just a little bit more. A little bit more upper body up. Okay? One more landing.
So lesson number 3 was Ethan's single loop. What I liked about that lesson was I feel that the progressions that I chose were really helpful for a skater feeling how to do a single loop. Because I think the boards helps the skater with their upper body positioning, and then also with their feeling that H position by tapping their toe on the boards. I feel like that's really helpful for them. So I liked the progressions, and I liked that I could see an improvement in his landing glide after we spent so much time on it. So yeah, what didn't work, I feel like the progression with the 3-turn and the clap, clap, clap was causing him to kind of lean on after his 3-turn hold. So he was dropping his right side and he was kind of crunching down, and I was trying to tell him to stand upright, but it just, it wasn't getting through to him. So, that wasn't, when I saw that, I was like, oh man, I should have spent more time on that. I did deviate from the lesson plan. I went through the progressions and then I sort of backtracked and went back to the beginning again, because halfway through the lesson, I feel like he needed more time on his, that 3-turn hold, because I could see his upper body just like drifting again. So I kind of deviated in that way. And then also I didn't expect to spend so much time on his landing position. And what would I have done differently next time? So after watching that lesson, I realized that I kind of sped through the first like 2 progressions. Next time, I would spend more time on the 3-turn hold, really working on that upper body positioning, like holding that left side strong in front, and I would do the three turn clap, 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 but I would also emphasize that not dropping that right side. So I would spend more time on those two progressions before I moved on to the progression at the board and then taking it to the single loop. I think that's where he needed most of the attention, and I think I kind of sped through that a little bit. So yeah, but I think he's a strong skater, and I'm totally excited to see him progress.